Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Aditya Gupta. So in this video, I wanted to tell you about the reality of the medical profession in India particularly. So I see a lot of comments where people are like that they're inspired by and motivated by my videos, and I'm glad that I'm able to inspire you, motivate you and contribute in a positive way. Having said that, since if you feel that you are getting inspired by me or you see me as my role model or whatever it is, I'm really grateful about that. But then I find it that it's my responsibility to tell you the reality of this field. I want people who are preparing for the NEET UG examination to be extremely sure about the decision that they are taking. It doesn't matter whether you're in 10th standard, it doesn't matter whether you're in 11th standard. Barmi to thodi der ho chuki hai. But in fact, abhi bhi der nahi hui hai for that matter. But the thing is that you have to be very sure about the fact that that you want to become nothing but a doctor. You know, a lot of people want to come into this field for the secondary benefits that are associated with this field. That is the thing that have good money. I'm not saying that doctors don't earn money. Yes, definitely. We are well paid. Definitely. Or the amount of respect that we command. Yes, definitely. We do command respect, but so do other professions as well. Be it an IAS officer. My father was an Air Force officer. He commands respect. My mother is in an insurance company. She's a chief manager. She commands respect. You can command respect and earn money through a multitude of other ways. An entrepreneur commands respect thanks to Shark Tank now. You have to realize that MBBS by itself and the journey to become a doctor, it's tough. Just by the virtue, if you look at it, it's close to 14 years. Your MBBS is 5.5 years. Your MD is going to be 3 years. Your DM is going to be 3 years. And every exam takes around 1.5 years to crack. So at least 14 years for a normal average student is what you're going to take to finally complete just being a doctor. And the actual struggle starts after that. So if you actually enter a medical college at the age of 17 or 18 or 19, you will be close to 33 or 34 years of age or 32 years of age by the time you're actually finished with your studies. And that's just one aspect of it. That's what I'm saying. So don't look for money or perks, because there are multiple other ways where you can earn that. Do it because if you want to help others, because this is the thing that you imagine, that, you know, going to the hospital and helping patients. The satisfaction that gives is unparalleled. I won't deny that. You know, do it because maybe you like working in high stress environment. There are a lot of people who excel working in high stress environment. I being one of them, I thrive in a high stress environment. And do it if you love the medical science, you know, the human body, learning about human body. For me, probably the biggest reason to become a doctor was not the money or the respect or the anything else. It's because I actually loved biology. It's actually because I still love science. For me, knowing about, let's say I'm doing my DM in pediatric oncology right now, learning about cancer, how cancer behaves, what can we do to treat it, what can we not do to treat it, learning about that still is the biggest motivation to keep on doing what I'm doing. The rest everything is just because of the virtue of the profession that I have to do. But for a lot of people, you do this not for these reasons. You do it because you think you'll get rich easily or you'll earn respect. I'm sorry, if you join for these reasons, you'll be in for a rude shock. Okay, because medicine in India is tough. And that's the reason a lot of people who do join for the reason take postgraduate entrance examination. The topest, you know, the ranks are people who are getting the highest ranks in PG entrance examination. They're choosing radio. They're choosing dermatology. Why? Because they want a work-life balance. They want a life where they're not that stressed. They want a life where they're free from the pressure of working in a hospital. If they have a work-life balance and they get settled early, right? So that is the thing. This is the reason in India, PG, derma and radio give highest. Versus, let's say you compare US or UK, they're neurosurgery, surgeons, ENT surgeons. They are the most sought after branches as compared to derma and radiology. And the other thing that I wanted to highlight is, especially in India, there's a problem of violence against doctor. We do not have a work-life balance. I came back right now after 24-hour duty. I mean, yes, there are 24-hour duties in other nations as well, but the amount of work that an Indian resident doctor puts in is unparalleled. There are weeks where I'm not able to meet Divya. There are days when I'm not able to come home. And I'm able to do it because I love this profession. You won't be able to do it if you're joining it for the secondary reasons that I mentioned, be it money or be it respect. You will only be able to do it if you actually love this profession. And recently the worries, and you know, and people make an image out of you. I make YouTube videos and then suddenly like to Dr. Neera. I make videos for you guys, NEET aspirants, telling you about, you know, whatever it is in my modicum, in my way, ki padlo, NCRT padlo. And people have a problem with that as well. Ki tu doctor ban, tu NCRT kyun padha raha hai, your level is DM. Bhai, meri marzi yaar. A doctor, if he wants to do in India, wants to do anything apart from being a doctor. He wants to be an entrepreneur. He wants to go to IAS. He wants to, go to MBA. People will be like, seat waste kar di. Yaar, uski marzi yaar, usko jo karna hai. We are judged in the public eye a lot. And you have to be prepared for that. And most importantly, the violence against doctor part, especially in India, is mind-boggling. Recently, a person just committed suicide because, yeah, delivery ke baad na, there is a lot of blood loss. That is called as postpartum hemorrhage. Post afterpartum pregnancy hemorrhage, blood loss. Because the placenta gets separated out and wahan se bahut sara blood loss ho raha hota hai. But what happens is that, and sometimes deaths do occur. It's the most common cause of death during childbirth. A person died, a mother died for that, because of that. I'm sorry, yeah, but the complications do occur. We are not gods. And us doctor ke upar murder charge laga diya yaar. Murder matlab preemptively usne decide kiya tha ki main marunga. Are you fucking kidding me? But this is the reality of this profession in India. We will be judged. Agar hum, people want us to work for 30 hours, not have a life. They want that. I posted a video of working for 30 hours, my hectic duty. Everyone loved it. I posted one pic of having a wine glass. Everyone lost their shit. Okay. Because somehow this is the perception in people's mind that a doctor should not be able to enjoy. He should just be a doctor. Aur kuch na kare. ठीक है चाहे वो YouTube क्यों ना हो IAS बनने जाते हैं लोग तो दे से कि तूने एक सीट वेस्ट कर दी मेडिकल कॉलेज की IAS तो कुछ भी ग्रेजुएशन करके कर लेता हाँ बट उसे डॉक्टर बनना था बाद में उसने रियलाइज किया IAS बनना तेरा क्या जा रहा है यार वी आर स्क्रूटनाइज फॉर नो रीजन इन द पब्लिक आई मनी येस इट्स देयर आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिनाई दैट बट देयर बेटर एवेन्यूज टू अर्न मनी रादर देन वेस्टिंग यू नॉट वेस्टिंग बट यू नो पुटिंग 14 ईयर्स एंड देन अर्निंग मनी ओके सो All I'll say is do it because if you're very, very sure you want to help people and that takes care of everything, do it because maybe you actually do like the really stressful environment. I do. Meko acha lagta hai. Kayo ko acha lagta hai. Kayo ko nahi lagta. Most people don't. That's why they take radio and derma. Chill life. Easy life. Theek hai? Do it if you love the medical body. If you love the body, human body and learning about human body and the medical science as a whole. Don't do it for the secondary profits. Okay, to the secondary reasons. You'll be in for a shock. You should know about this reality of the medical profession in India. Otherwise, you'll be in for a rude shock. And it is my responsibility as someone, if you say that I'm inspiring you, to tell you about the reality, to tell you the truth. So, thank you and have a nice day.